Hi students, welcome back. Now let's see the entire communication of cellular network. In the previous video, I explained what are the terms and terminologies that you used in the cellular network and what the exactly the cellular network was. Now let's see how the entire communication of cellular network will be established. Okay, so actually previously we are having the mobile systems. Okay, the mobile systems we are using, not the cellular networks. In the mobile system we are use only one powerful transmitter, that is only one base station. Use one powerful transmitter. Okay, only one powerful transmitter, that you transmitter you call it as a base station on high location. So let's take, suppose this is a area. Okay, so this is a coverage area. Let's take this is a coverage area. So in this coverage area we are using one high powerful transmitter. Okay, so the high powerful transmitter, so it covers the complete entire area. It's a large area it is covering. So in the mobile systems, so if you in the previous days we use only one powerful transmitters which covers the entire area. So here the range of the signals can be up to 50 kilometers will be there. The range of the signal, this signal is up to 50 kilometers. So whenever in this area up to 50 kilometers, only one transmitter will be there. Then what is the problem here? Here, what about the transmitter that we are using? It is a more powerful. Okay, more powerful means more expensive will be there. So obviously if the powerful is there, it is expensive. Okay, just keep the matter of expensive aside. The main problem here in the mobile systems, earlier mobile system, is where the only one base station which is a powerful transmitter is there. Here the frequency cannot be reused throughout the system. Frequency cannot be reused throughout the system. Throughout the system. Okay, that is a main drawback in the, that is a main drawback in the mobile systems. In the previous days, only one powerful transmitter which covers a large area. So the problem here is the frequency. Whatever the frequency, suppose this person is using somewhat of frequency base station. Okay, so these frequencies cannot be reused. Okay, suppose he leave that frequency, he cut the call, that means that frequency cannot be used by the other person. So there is, it is a main drawback. So that's why we say they develop the cellular system or the cellular networks. So here suggested that, and the cellular network suggested that multiple smaller transmitters will be there. Here one powerful transmitter, but in cellular system multiple smaller transmitter with less powerful. A transmitter is, it's nothing but a base station. Multiple base stations will be provided with less power, with less power, and here the frequency can be reused throughout the system. Okay, the frequency can be used throughout the system. So that is the main difference between the mobile systems previously and now we are using the cellular systems. Okay, now let's see how the entire communication will be established in the cellular system. Let me show you. In the previous video I just explained the architecture there, the terms that we used. Now I want to just explain it in simple words. So let us take, this is one base station, a transmitter is there, okay, and another base station in another location. Another base station Okay, suppose here a car is there, a car is moving. Okay, this is moving from one location to, in this way it is going, the car is going. Okay, so that in the car you're making a call and you're talking in the car. So whenever it reaches this point, it's using this base station. So like this, it is using this base station. Using this base station. It comes like this. whenever it comes to here, it disconnects this base station and continue with this base station. Okay, the call will be continuing. The call will be continuing throughout the line. So here, whenever this all base stations, whatever the base stations here are there, all base stations are monitored by the base station controller. So I said BSC, the base station controller is monitoring all the base station. So this, the mobile, whatever here we are using, that mobile is monitored by this base station controller and checks which base station will be suit for this mobile while on the road. Okay. And this base station controller will connected to the mobile switching circuit. This mobile switching circuit is telling whether in which location the mobile will be there. That is the HLR, home location register, and it having the visitor location register information will be there in the mobile switching center. Okay, and this is everything will be this connected to the internet. Actually, this is the process of this cellular communication. So here the entire communication process can be described by, first thing is a monitoring, first monitoring for strongest signal. First it monitoring the strongest signal. So when the mobile unit is turned on, suppose the mobile unit is turned on, it scan and select the strongest setup that are channels for the system. First it selects a base station. So which base station has to be selected? If the mobile is here, it selects this base station. If the mobile is here, it selects this base station. Okay, and then provides a handshake between the mobile unit and the mobile switching center. So just a handshake. Okay, I'm here in this mobile base station, nearer to this base station. Shall we take the signal of this base station? Just a handshake communication will be established. So this handshake is used for identifying the user and the registration its location. So the main use of handshaking here, the mobile unit and the mobile switching center is doing to identify, for identifying the user. Okay, for identifying user. So which user, is it a correct, we are sending the signal to the correct person or not, who is in the call. Okay, so it's identifying the user and the registration its location, and register its location. So where it register its location, the MCS, the mobile switching center, stores its location in, if it is a visitor, it stores in the visitor location register. If it is in a home, it is stored in the home location register. Okay, so the first communication process, it's monitoring the strongest signal, which base station it will be suited. And okay, so first it registration process is, everything is over. Next, what it is doing, it's request for connection. So first the call has came. Now if you want to lift the phone, the signal is request for the connection. The mobile unit, whatever the mobile unit originated, SL, by sending the number of called unit on pre-selected setup channel. Okay, then setup channel must be ideal. After that, a paging. Okay, so the next communication process is a paging. Here the mobile switching center or the mobile transmitter section sends or paging message to certain base station. Depending on the called mobile number, okay, it selects the base station depending upon the called mobile number. Each base station signal transmits a paging signal in its own assigned setup channels. Okay, so every base station has its paging signals will be there, and that will be has its own assigned setup channels. Okay, so next is call accept. So first identifying the user, after that request for connection, next the paging process will be done, next the call will be accepted. So the call accept, the called mobile unit recognize the user. Okay, I recognize the user and this is a exact person to whom I want to be talked on the set of channels being monitored and respond to the base station. That base station sends the response to the mobile switching center, set up circuit between the called and calling mobile unit. So there a connection will be established. Okay. There a connection will be established between the two persons. Let's say. So in this mobile base station, a calling person is there. Another base station, a called person will be there. A connection will be established between these two persons. So that is a call will be accepted. Okay. After the call has to be ongoing. Okay. You received the call and you are talking. After that, the call has to be ongoing. Let me take the fifth point here only. It is ongoing. First monitor, next request for connection, next paging, call accepted, next ongoing. So even though you are moving from one place to another place, the call should be in ongoing. When the connection is maintained, the mobile unit exchange their voice or data signals going through their respective base stations and mobile transmitter signals. Okay, so the call will be ongoing in whatever the place that you are shifting. So next is handoff. What is this handoff? Handoff means when a mobile user travels from one area of coverage. So this is one area of coverage. Okay, one area of coverage or cell to another area of another cell within a call duration, the call should be transferred to the new cell's base station. The call has to be transferred to the new cell's. So in this base station, another base station, another base station, so many base stations will be there. The call has to be transmitted to the new cell base station. Okay, the transfer in mobile cellular system design is called as a handoff. So this type of transferring the call from one base station cell to the another base station cell, you call it as a handoff. Okay, so these are the communication, entire communication process can be described like this. First is a monitoring the strongest signal in the cellular system. First monitoring strongest signal, next request for connection, paging, call accepted, ongoing call and handoff. Okay, thank you.